Provenance is very key to me because I have a responsibility to what I do. I'm interested in knowing that I've got a real product from real people in a real farm. I want to know what I'm eating and what I'm preparing. Now, we don't always sing and dance about it on the menu all the time, but I think our customers are interested in what we're serving and how we serve it and where it comes from. We do a lot of very familiar things, one of them being steak tartare. Now, steak tartare is a lovely, familiar brasserie dish. We use sirloin for our steak tartare, and we get strip loins from Paddock Farm in Oxfordshire. We chop up the centre fillet, no fat, no sinew or anything like that. And then we mix it with chopped shallots, mustard seeds, and a little puree that we make with gherkins and capers and mustard and things like that. Put chopped parsley, Czech seasoning, and we make it into a little patty. Now, in the middle of that, we put a golden egg yolk, a raw golden egg yolk from Clarence Court. They have these beautiful different heritage chickens that have these lovely eggs. These ones are the blue huge shells, Cotswold leg bar chickens. So we have a golden egg yolk in the middle of that. And then we cover the whole steak tartare in pickled carrots, little slithers of orange and burgundy and golden carrots. So it's a colourful kind of looking salad with all sorts of treats beneath. The raw egg yolk and the soft meat and the pickles all mix in. Now, on top of our steak tartare, we've got these little pickled mustard seeds on top, which are lovely. They pop in your mouth. They give a sour, crunchy, refreshing little zing to the finished dish. Now, to go with it, we have some fairly understated but rather spectacular oat biscuits. We have some of yesterday's bread, which is crispy little croutons. And we also have chips if you're into bigger versions. Now, the steak tartare is quite popular both as a starter and a main course. It's season proof, which is quite important for some of our menu because half of our menu doesn't change that much. And the carrots don't really get affected by the seasons too much. And the beef doesn't either. So it works really well with us to be a consistent dish that's always on the menu that some people can think, you know what, I want steak tartare at Parlour. Let's go there and let's have it. It's not like just eating a raw steak. There's skill in the sourcing the meat to begin with, then seasoning it, making it taste, texture, because texture is quite important to steak tartare. And then the presentation is also, first of all, you want someone to want to get into it. So it's got to look beautiful. But then after that, we want it to taste nice and feel nice and make them want to come and have a few more mouthfuls after that.